Today we will create a sales dashboard, but the data source will be MySQL Server database. MySQL Server is not supported like SQL Server. It requires a MySQL Server connector. And not all versions of MySQL Server connectors are supported. You must know which version is supported and install that one only. This makes it a little bit tricky. Sometimes, we fail to get everything right, and it does not work. MySQL is an open-source relational database management system that uses structured query language, SQL, for managing and manipulating data. It is widely used in web development, and is a popular choice for businesses, due to its reliability, flexibility, and ease of use. MySQL is capable of handling large volumes of data, and is scalable, making it suitable for various applications ranging from small personal databases to large-scale enterprise systems. Integrating MySQL with Power BI allows users to leverage the power of both tools for effective data analysis and visualization. By connecting Power BI to a MySQL database, you can create interactive and insightful dashboards, reports, and visualizations. This integration is valuable for businesses and analysts looking to make data-driven decisions based on their MySQL data. Let's start our tutorial and try to connect MySQL Server to Power BI Desktop. In the Power BI Desktop, open the Get Data window. In the Get Data window, search from MySQL. Select the MySQL database and press Connect. First time, you will see a message saying the required components is not installed. Click on the Learn More button. It will take you to the MySQL connector page. Do not download this. Instead, go to the MySQL information page. Here you can see which version is supported by Power BI. Go to the MySQL download page and click on the Archives. Select the supported version and click on the Download button. Wait for the download to complete. Start the installation. Install with your choice of setup type. Wait for the setup to complete installation, and then click on the Finish button. Now, go back to the Power BI Desktop, and try the MySQL database again. It will again give you the same error. But, don't worry. Just restart your computer, and try again. After restarting your computer, check for the MySQL connector in Power BI Desktop. It should work now. We have set up a MySQL server for our viewers. You can use it for practice. The server address and the credentials are placed on our website. Enter the server address and the name of the database. You can copy this information from our website. Paste the server address in the server field. Copy the database name and paste it in database field. Press OK. Choose the database credentials instead of Windows. Copy the username and password from our website and paste them in their respective fields. Press the Connect button. Press OK to all unencrypted connection. In the Navigator windows, select the Star Bakery table and click on the Load button. Let the data be loaded. Once the data is loaded, all the tables and fields will be available in the data pane, which you can use to create visualizations. First, add a text box visual to your dashboard. Enter a nice title for your dashboard in the text box visual. Choose an appropriate font size for your title. Now, add a pie chart or a donut chart to your dashboard. Place it at the bottom left corner of the dashboard. Add the total price field to the values area and rename it as sales. Add the order type field to the legend area. Make a duplicate of this chart and place it next to it. Replace the legend field with the product field. Make a duplicate of this chart too, and place it at the bottom right corner. Replace the legend field with the salesperson field. Add a line and column chart to your dashboard. Add the total price field to the column y-axis as sales. Add the weight field to the line y-axis. Add the date field to the x-axis without the days. Make room for another chart. Add a scatter chart to your dashboard. Add the day field to the values area. Add the total price field as sales to the x-axis. Add the weight field to the y-axis. Your MySQL dashboard is now ready. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates. You can ask any question or leave a feedback in the comments section.